Hello, happy people! I'm back with another video, and today I'm going to be reviewing some new gel polishes that I just got in from Nail Reserve. And so let's hop into the colors that I received. So they were kind enough to send me 8 more colors, so let's take a look see here. So these are all the colors that I got. So looks like I picked out a lot of neutral tones or nudes. So let's take a closer look at each color. So the first color we have here is Midnight Shine. Ooh, this is a really beautiful, rich, muted tone brown. Very, very pretty. Looks like some nice milk chocolate. Almond. Ooh, this is a really beautiful peachy nude color. Very nice. Beautiful base for tons of different nail art. Monchetti. Very beautiful. It's a nice nudie gray. And it looks like the stems of the brushes seem to be a little bit shorter than I remember. I have to go and take out one of my old bottles here to see. Okay, so this is a random purple called Province from them. Let's see if the brushes are a little bit different. No, they're about the same. I don't know why I'm remembering it being a little bit longer. I don't know, they feel more square. Maybe it's just me, I don't know. Next we have Nightshine. Ooh, it's a really beautiful, nice pure silver color. Very nice. Mountain Walk. Ooh, this is a really beautiful, nice blue color. It's a different type of blue though. It's like deep, but also muted. Really, I feel like this would be a really nice blue for the fall time. Misty. Ooh, it's a really beautiful, nice kind of off-white creamy color. Very beautiful. Eternity. Beautiful muted gray color. Beautiful muted brown color. Leans a little bit gray. Ambrosia. Oh, nice. This is a really nice light peachy nude color. Another great off-white base for some beautiful nail art. And last but not least, we have For a Lady. And this is a nice mauve nude color. Looks pretty similar to, color is this? Monchetti. Let's get them side by side. Yeah, they're pretty similar. Let's move these back a little bit. Yeah, these colors are pretty similar, but as you can see, the For a Lady is a little bit lighter, and the Monchetti is just a slightly, it's more purpley. Alrighty, let's get the swatching. Midnight Shine, really nice chocolate brown. Very pretty. It's a little bit translucent, so you'll definitely need to go in with 2 coats of this color, but it's really, really pretty. Almond, yeah, that's a really beautiful base color. I like this a lot. Monchetti. It smells so good too. Oh my goodness. Gorgeous. Night Shine. Beautiful. Misty. Eternity. Yeah, it's a really nice muted brown. I don't think I have any like this. Very nice. This one's definitely more opaque than that first brown. Mountain Walk. Very pretty. This kind of reminds me of like a deep teal green. Very pretty. Ambrosia. For a Lady. This is what all the colors look like swatched out. I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys up closes of each one. So the first one here is For a Lady, which is this really beautiful kind of muted mauve color. Ambrosia, which is this really beautiful creamy off-white color. Mountain Walk, which is this really beautiful deep teal slash greenish blue. Eternity, which is this gorgeous muted brown. Misty, which is another beautiful off-white color. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys Ambrosia. I'm gonna show you guys Ambrosia and Misty next to each other. They do look pretty darn similar. I would say that Ambrosia has slightly peachy undertones and Misty has more brown undertones, but I think if you had to pick one or the other, you don't need both. I'd probably go with Ambrosia. Night Shine, which is this really beautiful silver. I did have to go in with 4 coats of this polish, and even at 4 coats, there's still a little bit of translucency to it, so this one definitely needs to be built up for coverage. Mon Cheri, which is another beautiful muted mauve nude, and then I'll show you all that color next to For a Lady. Again, these two are also very similar. I think, again, you can get by with just one or the other. You don't necessarily need both. If you're going for more of a grayish muted undertone mauve color, I'd go with Mon Cheri. If you want more of a purpley, I'd go with For a Lady. We have Midnight Shine, which is really pretty. Then we have Almond, which is this gorgeous base for a lot of different nail art. So yeah, these are all the colors. I'm gonna show you guys how to get into some foil application. I've been wanting to show that on my channel here for quite some time. And so I'm gonna go in, I think, with Ambrosia. I think I'm also gonna do Moonwalk and then Almond. I'm gonna go in with these 3 colors and we'll do some different foils. So these are some foils that I just recently got in from Email Couture. And I wanted to go in with, I think, a few different ones. I think what I'm gonna do is, so whenever you're doing foils, you'll definitely wanna just cut out a little piece of the foil that you wanna put onto your nail. So with this one here, I think I wanna put it over the blue color here. And I'm just gonna do a white lace design. Just gonna pick which one I'm gonna use. See which one's gonna look really pretty. I think I like that one. I think I'm actually gonna go with this design right here. I'm just gonna cut just a little piece off, okay? Like so. Then for the gold, I think I wanna go in with Almond. No. I think I want to go in with this for the gold. Yeah, I want to try the flowers. I think that's pretty. That'll be cute. I'm going to go in with this on there. For this color, I'm going to go in with some flowers here. Kind of in the mood for some blue. That'd be really cute. Just do some blue flowers. Got some roses. Actually, I changed my mind. I'm going with some roses. This looks really cute. So go in with that. So that's how you pick out the foils that you'll be using. Next, what I'm going to do is go ahead and use all these colors. I'm going to go in with Ambrosia on this nail, Almond on this nail, and Mountain Walk on this nail, and do 2 coats of each one. Alrighty, so this is what 2 coats of coverage looks like. I think I'm gonna start off with the nail that has the flowers on it. kind of most excited about that. So whenever you're doing nail foils, you'll definitely want to go in with a good foil glue. I've really come to like my McCart nail foil glue. There's also one from Beatles that I really enjoy as well, but this one was just easily accessible. And with this, timing of curing and placing the foil is really important. So you'll want to go in first with a really thin layer of the foil glue over the entire nail. And this is going to give it a nice sticky layer so that the foil can adhere to. And you want it to make it nice and even. And I'm going to just flip it upside down to give it some time to self-level. Then the key with this foil glue is you want to let it cure for 60 seconds. And then you let it cool off for 30 seconds before going in with foil application. So I'm going to cure it for 60. And while that's curing, I did get in some new silicone tools during one of my scoops, and I want to give them a try in today's video. I'm trying to decide which one I want to go in with. I think I'm going to try this second one out over here. I'll try this one out. This one right here. I'm just going to take the two out and do this one. And then I'm going to take this one out. Okay. And then we're going to try these out. Oh, these are nice though. I like this. Okay. These are really nice quality too. I like these a lot. But we're going to use these to try to smooth out these foils. And I'm definitely going to need assistance because my nails are really long. Normally I'd rub it with my hands, but I don't think I'm able to right now. Okay, so it just finished curing for 60 seconds. Then you want to wait for 30 seconds. So I'm just going to hold this in my hand for about 30 seconds and then I'm going to go in with the application. Okay, so it's been about 30 seconds. And after that, you'll want to just take your foil and place it on the nail where you want it to be. So I think I'm going to go in like so. And that's perfect. And then I'll go in with my silicone tool. And now I'll just start rubbing and rubbing and rubbing. So the key with the foil is you want to keep rubbing until you can't rub anymore, essentially. And by doing that, it allows for the foil to transfer onto the nail without a lot of hassle. And what I found is that typically the foil will start to raise off of the nail by itself. So I'm going to go ahead and grip the ends here and continue rubbing. Like I say, you just keep rubbing, rub until you can't rub anymore. And once you feel like the image has a good hold, you'll just go in and remove the film like so. And like so, you guys, it transferred beautifully. Look at that. Look at that. Beautiful transfer. Wow. Yeah, that turned out really nice. Y'all see that? And that's how you do a foil transfer. Very, very beautiful. So next I'm going to go in with this gold lace. And I'm going to do that over this nail. So you do the exact same method. You go in with the thin layer of the foil glue. And you want a nice even coat. Like so. I'm going to hold it upside down. And then cure for 60. All right, so it just cured for 60 seconds. Now you have to let it cool for 30 seconds. Letting it cool for 30 seconds really helps that sticky layer become really good for the application of the foil. So you'll want to wait just 30 seconds. And then from there, you'll go in with the foil. You just want to make sure you place it exactly where you want it to be. I'll place it right about here. Perfect. And I'm going to go up and down first and then side to side. And I'll go ahead and take my tool to help assist with the rest. And if you can, you might want to wrap it around while you're transferring it. I think that helps a little bit as well. But yep, you'll just keep rubbing, keep rubbing, keep rubbing until you can't rub anymore. That transferred beautifully. It's already coming off, you guys. Wow. It didn't waste no time. It is already transferred. That's awesome. I like these silicone tools. They're really good quality. And another thing that's nice about when you're doing foils is when you see the foil start to lift while you're rubbing it, that means that the image has already transferred. Okay. And I'll just keep rubbing just a smidge more. And so now I'm going to take this and go ahead and remove it. And look at that. Perfect transfer. Beautiful. I think I got a little bit on my glue, but look at that. Pretty much the whole image transferred. That's awesome. Look at that. How beautiful, you guys. Oh my gosh. Yeah, that turned out beautiful. Love it. And then for the very last now, I'm just going to do that white lace design. So I'm going to go ahead and again go in with a really, really thin layer of this foil glue over the entire nail. You want to make sure it's nice and even. Okay, like so. And you turn it over for 30 seconds. Turn it over. And then you'll want to go ahead and cure for 60 seconds. It's cured for 60 seconds. Now you let it cool for 30. Okay. And then after it's cured for 30, you just decide where you want to place it at on the nail. That looks good to me. Then I'll go up and down, and side to side, just to get it in place. And then you just start rubbing and rubbing and rubbing until you can't rub anymore. And that will get that image to transfer over beautifully. My camera did just die, so I hope that I can still get this whole image to transfer. Like so. Looks like it's transferring beautifully. You'll just keep rubbing, and again, like I said, when you're rubbing and you see the image start to separate from the tool or from the nail, that's how you know that it has transferred properly. I'm going to show you guys the removal here. Use my hand. Beautiful, look at that. Beautiful transfer. Oh my gosh. Yeah, y'all, they all turned out really good. Oh my gosh. So I do really like that McCart foil glue. So this is what all three nails are looking like. And then the last thing you have to do is just go in with a top coat. So I'm going to seal in all of these with a top coat and we'll get into the finished look. Beautiful. Gorgeous. Flip it over to let it level and then cure. That's beautiful. Turned out really nice. Alrighty, so this is what all the nails look like with their foil applied, and I think it turned out absolutely gorgeous. So for those who have nail foils and you're curious about how to use them, it all depends on the foil glue that you have. Like I said, I found McCart to be a really good one, and the Beatles foil glue is also really good as well. I've done some tutorials with that. Actually, I have two dedicated videos that show how to apply nail foils, so I will go ahead and leave both of those videos linked down in the description box below, so that if you guys want more detail about how to apply foils, you could have it, or different kinds of foils foils that have been applied. I used to thought that it mattered the brand of the foils, but it doesn't. It matters your application and the foil glue. So yeah, these turned out really, really beautiful. I hope you guys enjoyed today's tutorial. So yeah, I had fun using all of the polishes that I got from Nail Reserve. Another special shout out to them for sending these over for review. They were some gorgeous colors. And again, these colors are really great for doing some amazing nail art. I do have a discount code with Nail Reserve. I'm going to leave it here on the screen as well as in the description box below in case you guys want to check them out. But love their polishes. I use them all the time. And yeah, I hope you all enjoyed today's video. Let me know, how do you all apply your foils and what foil glue do you use? I do have two other foil glues that I want to try out. I have the Star Foil Glue and I also have foil glue from Young Nails that I have yet to try. I've just been using my McCart because it's been working. So I do need to learn how to use air dry foil glue. I've not mastered that yet. But yeah, I do upload every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. If you all like what you saw here, definitely stick around, join the happy family. I'd love to have you. And as always, you guys, leave some love in the comments down below. And I'll see you in my next video. I hope you all have a wonderful, awesome, spectacular day. Bye.